All right, welcome back here on Mix 93. Michigan Tech women win it 65-29, the final score. And we've got the head coach of the Huskies, Kim Cameron, here. And coach, a little dicey in that first half of play. You guys came out and really dominated after halftime. What did you tell the team in the locker room there?
Well, we were really looking for, obviously they understand. They know they're at the point they understand when they're not playing as well as they're capable of. And I think they were pretty disappointed in themselves. What we asked for at halftime was leadership. And I think it was pretty clear who came out and wanted to be a leader and wanted to put the team on her back, and that wasn't Kylie Moxley, who, you know, obviously had to sit out a little bit in the first, but she came back out and gave us the spark that we needed, and the team just grabbed on from there, and that's what we needed. We needed somebody to put us on her back, and unfortunately we didn't have that in the first half. Like I said, we asked for some leadership, and she stepped up and got it done.
How about holding them just 2 field goals after halftime? Two.
Yeah, I mean, even in the first half, though, the score is 21-19 at the break, at the intermission, and I thought we were doing okay defensively. I thought we missed a couple help sides that I think we usually are. I think we're pretty good at our position defense. And so we even though they had only scored 19 points, we were still a little bit disappointed. We challenged them. We had some help come from a couple different places, and I think we forced some tough shots, and really we rebounded well, and that was huge to be able to get the stops, get the rebounds, and then I think obviously I thought Kylie sparked us.
Kelleher, once again, nice job by her off the bench, and continues her string of double-digit games at 12 points. Assess her performance.
I think that was really good for her to be able to, she had a high last weekend, and it was kind of the first time she had been consistent for 2 games, and this was another challenge for her in her freshman year. Isn't that funny to say? Freshman year. She's so young, so she's tiptoeing around to see if she's for real. She tested herself. Am I for real? Am I as good as everybody keeps telling me I am? And the answer is yes. And I'm really happy for her, just because this continues to build confidence, and hopefully it starts to become an expectation.
Danny Blake, just 4 points in the game, but I think her impact was felt much more on the defensive end. Gabor came in averaging 16.5 points a game. She had 2 tonight.
She had 2, and that was where that was where Danny put her efforts today. I thought she had a great rip to the basket to start in the first quarter.
Yeah.
And I thought she needed to continue to go to the basket. I think a couple people got blocked, and I think that put a couple of our other girls on their heels. But yes, defensively I thought she was awesome, because Gabor has the ability. I mean, again, like you said, she's averaging 16 a game, and she shoots really tough shots off of tough screens and step backs and things like that. So she did a great job on her, and that was, again, our goal was defense.
Big one coming up, Coach. Ashland Eagles, now you can turn your attention to them. You got them on Saturday. It'll be a battle of division leaders. Obviously, they're number 7 in the country. You're looking for a little revenge. Give us a little preview of that one.
Yeah, there's nothing that we can say as a staff to get you fired up for this game. I mean, this is awesome. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be a great atmosphere, I think. It's going to be good, solid basketball. I think every point is going to be earned. You're going to have to work for everything. It's going to be, we're going to have some sleepy kids on the bus ride home. Hopefully we're happy and sleepy, but they have the same post players that they had last year. They were very, very young. They have 2 of the same starting guards and 1 new guard who played some minutes, but not a ton. Their point guard is extremely fast. They're running the same offense, so they look for that overload on the one side. They skip the basketball. They go inside out. They have Doherty. They have Schneider. Really, really tough to defend. I mean, they are tough to defend, and we're going to have our work cut out for us, but it's the biggest challenge that we've had, and I think it's in the right time right now. Let's see where we're at. Let's see what we're made of.
Looking forward to it. Again, congratulations. Great game, especially that second half. It was a lot of fun. You guys really put it on them, and really fun to watch Kylie, like you said, take over the game and really dominate. Good to see a senior do that.
And I think the other thing to mention is I thought we finished well. Our last 5 minutes, which is something that we really wanted to improve on from last weekend. I thought our last 5 minutes was awesome. We did a great job of taking care of the basketball, getting stops, which was something that we didn't do the way that we should have, and really proud of our second group that came in.
All right, that's Coach Kim Cameron and our Aspires Keweenaw Coach's Corner. Thanks a lot, Coach.
Thank you.
And we'll look forward to Saturday's game.